two keepers.
Young Dream. Yeah.
Streets knew me. Since I was a little nappy head nigga, way before I started smoking, or ever made a figure. Way before I started to rap, I was rocking my cousin's sneakers and starting for scraps. I just wanted a little brother, plus hand me some change. So at night, I pray for miracles, and shit never came. Pair Skippies on my feet, running fog for the winter juice. Couldn't get the Timbs, dog, couldn't get the triple hoop. Couldn't get a chain, stepfather stole my ring and sold it. Just so he could smoke some cook cocaine. Enough was enough for being legit. Me and Nat started doing all types of shit. Breaking open soda machines and passing them out. All the niggas know on my name, I'm happening now. Mama moved me out the city of BK. Back to being all by my lonesome, we headed to VA.
The streets knew me, never had it goldie. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me. But the streets knew me, soldiers to a general. Cradle to the grave, outstanding in the funeral.
Way before I became J Dread, before I ever lit a blunt and planned a blaze of the head.
Right.
Way before I sold me some crack, before I ever copped the bottle, and pour me some yak. Life changed, new step pop, in a new state. Never frontin' like I'm hard, kept the dude safe. Never holdin' like I'm soft, niggas steady knowing. Early signs of being great, I'm already showing. Got a job, same time, started stealing clothes. Knew it wasn't right, but it kept the boy feeling dope. Got high with that first time 11th grade. Couldn't imagine I'd be blazing like I do today. Graduated to community college, but instead of pursuing the knowledge, I'm moving to Scama. Got arrested, lost the weed, plus stuck in the jail. Hope the judge let me out, cause mama ain't got bail. Hell.
The streets knew me, never had it goldie. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me. But the streets knew me, soldiers to a general. Cradle to the grave, outstanding in the funeral.
Way before I became Young Trees, before I pointed guns at George saying, give me the cheese. Before I ever tried to get a deal, I was selling crack for a living so I could get a meal. Bad record, can't get a job paying more than $6. But I can make 600 in 6 hours. I'm flipping powder, hard getting sour. Cook it up, sell it all, now I'm getting power. Me, D, and Wise, dog, we getting hours. We distribute the work, call us Martin Brower. I distribute the hurt, call me Tiny Lister. Gripping guns, both hands, palm got the tiny blisters. When I'm in jail, call me inmate Fisher. Got the juice aiming at you, nigga, you could call me Bishop. Now switch up, spit straight vicious. I'm sunning niggas like they pop, make them do the dishes.
The streets knew me, never had it goldie. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me. But the streets knew me, soldiers to a general. Cradle to the grave, outstanding individual. The streets knew me, never had it goldie. Riding by my only, these niggas don't know me. But the streets knew me, soldiers to a general. Cradle to the grave, outstanding individual.
All right, everybody in the house today. Welcome to Bottom to the Top Show. Jon Fisher, the Microwave, Jerzey, Vern, the Chief Rocker. I am one half of the tandem, Mr. Patty Cake, Microwave, and my partner.
Boom shakalaka, it's the Chief Rocker, Jerzey Vern, on this Saturday, February the 20th, 2016. We're coming live and direct at you. The bottom to the top, it's nothing new. It's just that you haven't heard us because we've been deep underground. Now it's time to rise to the top. What's up, my main man, Michael Wade?
Man, I'm chilling, Jerz, man. Good to have you back in the house, man. We are live in studio together. That's something we've been doing as of lately. And it just seems that the show's been going way more better since we've been doing it live together. Now, where you want to start, man? Well, we got to tell everybody where we started, right?
Yeah. First, that introduction, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I'm quite sure there's some people that's on here that don't know about the bottom to the top. They know about you as being Jon Fisher, the Microwave. They know about me as being Chief Rocker, Jerzey Vern, straight out of the TDSS show, you know? So now we're going to introduce them in our own fashion, you know? Hey, the Chief Rocker and the Microwave, we go back, a year ago when me and the Jungle Brother, I'm quite sure a lot of y'all know Jungle Brother, Real Cash Ranger Radio, we all part of that. when we started this thing up. The Microwave was one of our protégés. And the reason he got the name Microwave, because he just blew up like Vinny the Microwave coming off that Detroit Piston bench.
Yes, sir.
So we just had a reserve. Whenever somebody was down and out or couldn't make it, the Microwave, Jon Fisher, stepped in there and he did his thing, man. You know? So what's your little history, Fish?
Well, you know, that's kind of how it was. You hit it on the money. I started out, uh-oh. We got Curtis Brown. Who's that Brown? In the building.
Oh my God. Hey, he's just not Curtis Brown. He's not just Curtis Brown. He's triple platinum.
Triple platinum, Curtis
from
Brown.
The D.
From the Detroit. D.
Yes, sir.
Well, your ass will get slapped. Anyway, yeah, man. So basically, I started out with you and Jungle Brother. Once I found y'all, I had to dig deep under the sewers to come find y'all. And I don't know if you remember when I first came in there, I'm like, well, how y'all got a show? And I don't know about it. You know what I'm saying? And y'all was pretty much saying to the tune that y'all wasn't trying to, you know, overstep no boundaries. And y'all was just doing y'all's thing.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I started out as a glorified caller. Me and you stayed going heads up in the NBA playoffs. You know, and, you know, y'all took a liking to me. I took a liking to y'all. And I had always wanted to do my own little sports talk show or whatever, but, you know, once I didn't have any type of avenues, I didn't know what I was going to do, and then y'all pretty much showed me the way and pretty much led me into just coming out with my own show.
Yeah, that's what's up right there, and shoot, man, you passed me, you know, you leaped bounds to pass me, but, you know, it's all good because we all family, you know, we got this real Cash Ranger Radio. You know what I'm saying? Where it starts off with the Zen Master, Jungle Brother. We call him the Zen Master because he think at times he Phil Jackson. He's building a dynasty over here with, you know, with people outside of me and the Microwave that's trying to do something. We got a young lady named, and everybody should know, Thorny Switch. We got another young lady out of Charlotte, Carolina, named Dr. K. We got Dollars and Cents. We got Ron Leary from down South Georgia by the Florida borderline. And then we got Everyday People Show with Gary G. Morning Joyner. So that's the real Cash Rangers.
Not to mention, we got that Ninja the Diplomat.
Yes, sir.
And Sluggo the Hammer, he's definitely a real Cash Ranger. He just chooses not to speak. You know, he's just always there supporting us with everything we do. We got a lot of supporters, man. We've grown a lot, you know, primarily thanks to all the hard work that Jungle and you put in, really laying the foundation. You know, Jungle, he wear a lot of hats, man. Jungle be out there producing shows, doing his own show. He's now a station on Spreaker. Started off as a broadcaster, and now he's pretty much a station in our jersey. Now, you know, let everybody know what made you start doing the Monday Recap Show, man.
Because, you know, me and Jungle, we were so used to being together with one another to the point where he told me I outgrew him. You know, I need to do my own thing. You know, first of all, he said me and the Microwave need to do a show because together, man, you know, we ain't even started yet. We just doing introductions right now. Because once we start a show, you'll see why we blend together. But first of all, he said, I need to get out there and do my own thing. It took me a while because I really don't want to do this technical thing. I don't want to be running boards. I don't really want to do all this and that. I'll talk for you. I'll talk 4 hours straight if you want me to. But if I got to start running my own shit, then, you know, it kind of like threw me back for a loop. So, hey man, I got into it. I started learning how to do all that. Now I have my own thing going. I got a little studio set up in my house, in my dining room, you know. So, hey man, I'm ready to blast off. But today is all about the Bottom to the Top show featuring a new beginning, you know, where we're going to start now. And we're going to start making things happen. We're going to make sure that we rise up to the top because cream is good when it's up on top of things. You know, when it sinks down, that means it's garbage. So, you know, it ain't nothing garbage here, man, because everything here is fresh and so smooth. you know. So, and that's how we're going to bring it. Smash, fresh, and smooth, you know.
And there you have it, folks. Listening to the Bottom to the Top show, and that's pretty much how everything started, how everything formed together from the beginning to the present, and now we leading up into the future, man. So we're going to have a good show for y'all tonight, man. One of the best friends to the show is supposed to be either calling in or having a special visit. For all of y'all who listen to the show, who are listening now, y'all know who exactly we're talking about, man. Our good friend of the show. And he comes through sometimes, bless her with gifts. Uh-oh. We got the sports governor of Minnesota, Vince Wright, the big smooth, the big schmeezy in the building.
Bumble claw. Boom, boom, boom.
Yes. What's up, Vince?
Gunshot from our governor there.
Yes, sir, Minnesota.
What up, Gov?
Yeah.
Representing the state of Minnesota.
And guess who snuck in?
Who else snuck in?
Bunny Rabbit himself.
Mr. Bunny Rabbit?
Yes, sir, Mr. Bunny Rabbit himself.
We got the Zen Master, Jungle Brother, the creator and innovator of Real Cash Radio in the building. Gunshot to the Zen Master there. All right, y'all, we gonna get this shit rocking, man. Jerzey, where you wanna start at with this sports stuff, man?
Oh man, shoot! It was a rough NBA night last night, man. Uh-huh. You know, we just coming back off of, you know, 10-day being off. When was the last time, you know, the NBA off 10 days, man? I mean, come on, be real. You know what I'm saying? After the All-Star game,
they said this was the longest break ever.
Yeah, they're getting soft, man. I mean, the NBA I remember is All-Star weekend, Tuesday night, you back to playing. Uh-huh. You know? Here there's All-Star weekend, Thursday, Friday night, you back to playing.
Uh-huh.
You know? I mean, come on. Give me a break. You know, they don't need that much time off. There's only 20-something games left to the season. Tough it up, because those who make the playoff, you're going to need that time and that practice and that hard running up and down the court to be ready for the playoffs.
True.
You know? So if you're taking these breaks, man, all you doing, because I seen a couple of guys last night gasping for air. So what were they doing during the break?
They was partying, man. It was partying. They were sitting at home, eating ice cream, partying, you know, drinking, doing whatever. They wasn't doing no. You already know, man. Cats come back from the All-Star break, and then especially you got all the folks who didn't make the All-Star game. What were they doing, you know, from the moment before?
That's the cats
and after.
I'm talking about.
Okay,
I'm talking about the ones that ain't been doing nothing. You know, what have they been doing? You know, that's my
Nothing.
Thing. You know, but hey, man, they started off last night with a bang, and I kind of figured this would happen. Golden State, they better watch out. Not just because they lost last night. A loss would have been a loss to me. But the way they lost, they got blown the fuck out.
Well, see, I think that's something that they needed, though, Jerzey. You know what I'm saying? Ever so often, you need a reminder that, hey, you're just a team. You can't get that ass whooped at full strength. You know what I'm saying? So I think they're going to respond. I think they're going to respond real well.
Well, they
to
better
that
start
loss.
Tonight. They got the Clippers tonight.
Yeah.
And the Clippers just...
Well, see, now the Clippers are going to be the suckers who end up getting their asses whooped. To me, at least. If I, you know, I could be wrong. The Clippers could end up being the victims of when you piss these motherfuckers off.
Well, this is my thing. This is my thing right here. Right? I said a long time ago before the break... Right before, after I finish this, we got somebody to announce. But I said before the break that the West is going to catch up to Golden State, because right now you had San Antonio right on their heels, which they beat. You had the Thunders right on their heel, which they beat them too.
Mm-hmm.
But they have three more games with each one of these teams.
Mm-hmm.
So my theory is the rest of the West is like, hey, if they beat each other up, that opens the door for us to get in there and sneak and whoop that ass too.
Yeah.
And the West is the strongest thing that's going in basketball right now. And so it's going to be a knock'em sock'em. One of the weakest teams in the West can get up one day and do something to you.
Yeah, you're right.
You know?
You're right.
So my thing is, tonight is the featuring of the new player that the Clippers picked up. And that's my boy out of Georgetown, Green.
Gerald Green?
No, his name, Green. His name ain't Gerald.
It's Jeff Green, right?
Jeff Green.
Yeah, Jeff Green.
Yeah.
All right, well, before we get back into that, we got my man, Busta Bus, out there in OKC, driving to OKC. He's listening. He say he ain't going to be able to chat, but either way, he is in the building.
Put my glove.
Gunshot for me boss there. Bossing out your blood clot, my dog. Anyway, I think that was a good pickup for them, but at the same time, we're going to have to see, because that's what we said when he went to Memphis. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yes, sir. But you know what, man? This one thing about our show, for people that not used to a show that read chat, we read chat, you know what I'm saying? And I have a little segment of chat that I want to read, mm-hmm. because we have two of our people, and that shows you how deep a family is, because we can feud with each other, but at the end of the day, we're going to go back and love one another.
Oh, we feud all the time.
You know? So Vince Wright says, Bunny Rabbit, what's up? I guess he's referring to, we called Jungle Brother, you know, that Bunny Rabbit when he came in. But, you know, that's just a little slang that we throw at one another once in a while. We throw something at each other. And so it got a little deep in the chat. Vince Wright says, so see, catch on video smoking weed in Nashville. Here comes the circus. I really don't know what Vince was going at with that, but Jungle Brother came back, a little voices, you know, just to let you know that our chat room is a little tough. If you're not thick-skinned, you can't hang in this chat room with us.
Yeah.
Jungle Brother said, my name, Jungle Brother, God, that's my name. You ain't ready for a verbal war with me. I'll do a 2-hour show telling everybody why. And that's Jungle Brother. And he said, your name should change to Uncle T.O.M. Vince Wright, Governor, don't fuck with me.
Gloves is off. Gloves is off, man. Oh, Lord.
Deep right there,
it's
boy.
2 o'clock on a Saturday.
It's 2 o'clock
on a Saturday. They firing shots up in this, man.
Oh, man. You know what? Being that shots was thrown that way, I want to throw a couple myself.
Okay.
We got 2 shows on the SME, right?
Uh-huh.
We got more than 2 shows. We got Kicking It With Kizzy. We got Cooking With The Microwave. Mm-hmm. Those 2 shows I really love.
Mm-hmm.
Then we got The Grizz.
Mm-hmm.
And then we got The Barbershop Harmony, whatever they call themselves. First of all, if you're going to call yourself the Barbershop Show, you need to do the show in a barbershop with actually people in there getting their hair cut. You know? I mean, if your equipment is good, you know, you can be away from that noise, but then you can go interview somebody once in a while and let people feel the barbershop. Don't you here and your partner over there and you talking about sports, but you call yourself the barbershop. That's not the barbershop.
Well, they metaphorically speaking, though, Jerzey. I mean, you know, to me, I like the name of the show because, I mean, they're pretty much saying that what they're going to be talking about is stuff that you hear in the barbershop. Don't mean they got to be in the barbershop. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I mean, cut the boys a little bit of slack, man.
Well, I don't even call it like I hear. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't get a chance to listen to the show. I like the name of the show. Like,
I listen to it. It's 2 young guys, like, man. 2 young guys. I think they're more of a puppet show type show. You know, where everything they mostly doing is from the puppet show, not they hard or right straight off the dome, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a lot of note reading type thing. A barbershop show is where everybody get in there and just talk straight up ish about sports, you know. That's how I look at it. You know, I'm going to catch slack behind it, but you know, who gives a damn? I'm the Chief Rock. I'm Jerzey Vern. I don't give a damn. Vince
That's
in there.
My partner.
Vince in the chat room talking about that sound lame. But you know what, Vince? You better get used to it because, see, when I talk the way I want to talk. You know, I don't have to be politically correct for any damn body. You know what I'm saying? That's just like the Grizz. Y'all don't like how the Grizz is. I don't really give a damn about the Grizz because I can go at the Grizz. You know what I'm saying? I wish one day me and you, the bottom to the top, can challenge the Grizz show because I think that would be a real good battle. East Coast, West Coast. You show me what you know and we'll show you what we can do.
I mean, you know what?
That's
maybe
just
we'll,
me,
maybe we'll see. Maybe we'll see if we can get in contact with the Grizz. Maybe he can have us on his show and vice versa. I mean, real talk, I don't agree with what the dude says, but I like his passion. You know, I don't agree with, I think we agreed on like one thing. He was, I think he said something, he was going at Peyton Manning after the Super Bowl or whatever, but like, for the most part, I don't agree with what he says, but at the same time, like, I like his passion. And, you know, dude really, he you know, he kind of remind me of Skip Bayless a little bit, you know what I'm saying? You know, in his own right, like, he believes what he believes. He got his reasons why he believes it, and he stand fast until somebody going to make him, you know, change his ways or whatever. But,
yeah,
I mean, you know, he has a good show, though, regardless. I need to go check back. I'm going to go check out that Barbershop show.
Yeah, probably definitely later do on that. Today. Definitely do
See
that.
See what those cats are talking about.
I never said the Grizz ain't have a good show. It's just that a lot of people ain't used to the ish talking and how he present things and what he say in his show.
Yeah, well, I mean,
well, see, I like that. You know why
yeah.
I like that?
Uh-huh.
Because I'm the type of person, if he want to challenge me and you to our abilities and the talent on far as sports talk, he can do that. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm not going to sit up there with a bunch of papers scrambling through it and whatnot. I'm coming right off the dome because I'm older than this cat, and I think I know a little more than him. So he really had to go deep into sports to try to find out some of the shit I know.
Well, you know me. I scramble around with paper, too. I don't scramble around. I know, I mean, but you know, I know what I know.
But do people hear you scrambling now?
Nah, nobody going to hear me scrambling.
Okay.
Ain't nobody gonna hear me. You might hear me popping open a beer or something like that, lighting up a cigarette.
Yeah,
or,
you know.
I mean, but you know,
jiggling a little ice. You know what I'm saying? Jiggling a little ice or something like that.
Tell my folks what we sipping on, Jerzey.
Oh man, we sipping on some Apple Crown. You know, I'm really not a whiskey man, but you know what? Me and my partner, that's what he got. His flavor. I'm going to go with what he got. You know what I'm saying? I'm not one of them bougie conservatives, motherfucker. Like, only drink Dom Perignon. You know what I'm saying? You know,
nah, we ain't like that right here. We from the underground, man.
We from out the streets. You know what I'm saying? Brooklyn, Jersey up in the house. That's what it is.
Uh-huh. All
you
day.
Know, straight up.
Governor says, run the board, Bunny Rabbit. Run the board. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Anyway.
Yeah. Anyway.
So, something I want to talk about. We're going to bounce around from subject to subject.
Yeah.
So, we'll bounce back from sport to sport, whatever comes up. Buster Bustle, like he's sipping on some Henny.
Oh, yeah.
Or that's what
he
likes to drink.
Buster made a statement, not to cut you off, partner.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he said that the cats, he listened to the cats, too.
Mm-hmm.
The barbershop crew.
Yeah.
Right? The no-cutting hair motherfuckers, right? And they dissed the Redskins, and they coming out of Baltimore, D.C. area. One cat said he was a Raven fan, but the other cat was straight out of D.C. The Raven fan is an ex-brother from out of Brooklyn that likes the Yankees, the Knicks, the Ravens, and I don't know what other team he got, you know.
Yeah.
But that's what I caught.
Uh-huh.
And Buster said, the cat from D.C., this the Redskins.
So
you know what we going to do for you, Buster? We going to diss him. That's what we just did.
Hold on. Why he gotta like the Redskins? Because he's from fucking D.C. Why that man gotta like the Redskins when he's from D.C.?
Well, that's what Buster's saying, man. You know what I'm saying? And Buster's one of our favorites.
Yeah, Buster is one of our favorites. He's our resident Washington football team advisor.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
I mean, look, Buster, the man don't gotta like the Redskins just because he's from D.C. You know what I mean? Come on now. I mean, don't get me wrong. I would say 95% of... read that. I remember 95% of about DC residents root for the Redskins, but you know, I mean, there's 5%. Curtis Brown out there in the chat room, he said, I'm down with you, Vern. Barbershop, Puppet Factory-ish. Whatever, bro. I'm down with Jerzey. Hey, man, Curtis Brown, you allowed to cuss up in here, because that's what we do.
That's right.
But, I mean, if you type ish, I'm going to read ish. Governor asked what y'all sipping on, fish on the kush. You know it, Gov. You know it, Gov. Because he likes the Steelers, Buster says.
Yeah, he
did. Buster called him a buster.
I hear you, baby. Hey, that's man. Real. But you know, this is the bottom to the top show. You know, mm-hmm. Chief Rocket Jerzey Vern, mm-hmm. the Microwave Jon Fisher, Patty mm-hmm. Cake, Patty Cake. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's a Saturday, you know, afternoon, beautiful day, you know. And, you know, we just decided we had to do what we got to do. I mean, we used to have a time set on Wednesday evening and Thursday evening, but that kind of like slipped away, you know, mainly because of the weather, you know, and then I was sick for a minute. But, you know, right now we just going to sit back and get a schedule together on how we really want to do this, man. But whenever we come on the wave line, we're going to bring the people with us due to the fact that, hey, man, we're going to come here and we're going to bring you what you need and what you want, you know? So all I ask you to do is just sit back, ride, sip, and enjoy the show.
All right. Jerzey, something I want to talk about. One of my favorite, who I think he's probably the best center in the league, Boogie Cousins, man, in their win versus the Nuggets last night, he had 37 points and 20 rebounds. Like, a lot of people want to get on Boogie because of his attitude or whatever, whatever, whatever. But, I mean, he's okay. Governor says First Lady listening. First Lady, what up? What up? But anyway, back to Boogie Cousins. Wait. Let me not disrespect the First Lady like that. Yeah. She's listening out. If she was in the chat room, I would have did it automatically. But we got the First Lady of Minnesota Sports Talk, Angie Wright, Miss All Conference. What you got about that, Gov? Miss All Conference in the building. Rumble claw. Woo, woo, woo. Gone shot from the First Lady there.
Well, I'm like the Gov. She got to show me that paper.
Man, I believe her. She probably got more skills than Gov. Like I told
you,
Gov,
think
man.
So?
Gov don't want none of this work on that basketball court. I don't care if he's 6'5 or not. I guarantee you, I tear Gov ass up on that basketball court.
Ooh,
tear hey. Your ass up,
y'all
Gov.
Must have had a fine show last night if y'all talking about.
Nah, this was like a couple weeks ago.
A couple weeks ago?
When it was, who was it, Grego and Jungle was talking about, oh, you short this, you short that. So then somebody said, oh, nah, Gov is 6'5. Uh-huh. And I read it in the chat room.
But you notice something, man? Mm-hmm. 2'6'5 Duke Jokers, Jungle Brother and the Gov, they always talking about, you know, somebody being too short. Okay, that's 2'6-something Jokers, right? And neither one of them got any type of ability to move right now. one of them having a hard time getting up and down in the truck, and the other one having a hard time walking around the governor's mansion. So how are they going to challenge somebody to anything?
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? You know, so, hey, man, you know, my money riding on me and you.
Yeah, I'll take that. I'll take
you
that.
You know what I'm saying?
Whoa, look out. We got the diplomat, that ninja, the host of the Underground Railroad show in the building. Dipset. What? Ow. What up, diplomat? Well, I'm glad you're here now, because what I was trying to transition into real quick, Jerzey, and I want your opinion on this. Like, is there still no determination on whether or not Johnny Manziel will be charged for the accusations from the young girl saying that he pretty much ruptured her fucking eardrum?
Well, if you want me to get politically correct and go on off of hearsay news and all that, I'll say yes. But if you want me to just come from the dome and give my opinion, ain't shit gonna happen to that little Weasley ass goddamn runabout, spoiled-ass brat kid that's out of Texas, because as long as his daddy got money, as long as his daddy got people in his pocket, ain't nothing going to happen to Manziel. He may not play no football next year. You know, he may sit out a year, but ain't nothing legally going to happen to him. And I'll put money on that.
I don't think he got enough talent to be able to sit out a year and be able to come back into the NFL. I mean, you think so?
Well, listen this. They got jokers that ain't that's in the NFL every year, and they making it on teams, and ain't worth a squat. So why can't he go sit out and come back again?
Well, I mean,
you know what I'm saying?
He ain't really showing.
You know what it is?
Because people, he shouldn't be able to come back because Vince Young wasn't able to come back, and Vince Young didn't have no issues with domestic violence. Vince Young didn't have no issues with alcohol. Oh, we got somebody taking shots at you in the chat room.
No. They're not taking shots. He just wanted to voice his opinion. The Jungle Brother just came back from probably going to crack open a can or whatever he drinking favorite. He just said, I'm 6'3", 300 pounds. I ain't challenging nobody on no basketball court. I'm into boardroom challenges, son. I am almost 50. That ship been sailed. Well, I hear you, sir. I hear you. You know, ain't nothing wrong with that. You know, Buster Bus said, we reading a little chat right now. I'm short. Buster said he 5'8", but that's the only thing short on me. Laugh.
Uh-oh. We got Patriot loving my man, the stat man himself, Grego.
That's too short for him. We got the sushi rice eating, green tea out of the Boston Harbor drinking, the dirty green tea, the always controversial Brady loving ass. Go ahead.
Grego in the building. I whenever Grego's on with me, I can't say nothing about gunshots. Cause there was one time when it was me and Grego, and I forget who else was in the chat room with us, and I had mentioned that, and then the actual gunshot went off. So, you know, whenever Grego's in the building, you know, I gotta kind of be quiet when I, you know, about saying the word gunshots. All right, so not trying to get me and Jerzey shot up in here. You know what I mean? Jerz, what you think about Lillard's performance last night, man? He had 51 points, 7 assists, 6 steals. Of course, the Portland Trail Blazers beat the hell out of the Golden State Warriors. Now he is the first player in NBA history, since the stat has been recorded back in 73-74, to ever record 6 steals.
Well, all I can say is somebody defense was exposed last night. I'm going to be like Walt Clyde Frazier. It was like a man of door defense last night when Lillard was going to the hole. So, Curry, I think you better step up your manhood, because that man took you to straight lead to school last night. You know what I'm saying? You may be a good offensive shooting player, but you better sharpen up them defensive tools, because that man took you to school last night. You and Livingston.
Well, I mean, well, let's keep it 100, though. Let's keep it 100.
That is 100.
I'm saying let's keep it 100, though. Like, anybody can get got. Anybody, just because Steph Curry's been having a remarkable season, don't mean he can't get got. We acting like Dame Lillard is a scrub or something.
Oh, no.
Dame Lillard, one of the top point guards in the league. If he get cooked, he get cooked.
Well, I'm going to put it to you like this.
It was Dame Lillard's night last night. Career high, 51 points.
I'm going to put it to you like this, right? If you get scorched like that, and you was said that you was one of the top 7 defensive point guards in the league, and they said this about Curry now.
Uh-huh.
What happened last night?
Top 7. Okay, so what about when Steph Curry made Kawhi Leonard spin around in a circle and he was eating up Kawhi? That don't mean Kawhi's not a good defender. Kawhi just got that night. But look, I played ball. You know what I'm saying?
Hold up.
My thing is this.
Well, how many did he get got
always,
for?
There's always somebody that's going to get you.
Okay, well, how many did he get got for?
Who, Kawhi?
Yeah.
I don't know how many he got for.
It wasn't 51.
But you said he was eating up Livingston too, so it wasn't just Curry for the whole 51.
Yeah, but.
You know what I mean? Everybody gets got.
Yeah.
Every jersey. Well, my, look, okay. I'm ball, man. Everybody had a day. We just like, yo, I can't do nothing. This dude is busting my ass.
I'm going to tell you something. Coming up in the streets of Newark and the five boroughs of New York playing ball, my days, if a man got your number, it's something you're supposed to do. And if that means pulling that jersey, pulling them shorts, you got to throw that man off his rhythm.
Yeah.
And it looked like this was the NBA.
These are the millennials.
Well, hold up. This was like, this was the NBA All-Star game last night, the way he was lighting it up. True. And the whole team got lit up.
Maybe that was his statement. Did Lillard make the All-Star team this year?
Nah.
Maybe that was his statement. Because who was in there? It was Curry, Westbrook, and CP3 were the point guards, right?
Right.
Maybe that was his statement to be like, yo.
Well, if that's the case, it's a couple other guards going to make some statements too then.
Like who?
So if I was...
like who? Look, see, you ain't never believe in Golden State, man. I was telling you about Golden State. That's what your problem is.
Well, you know
that's
what?
That's why you take you know that what? Standpoint. You haven't got the ass.
No, it ain't that I don't believe in them, because I seen them. And they Mark Jackson team.
Uh-huh.
It's just that I'm mad about how they did Mark. So I can never root for them.
But it's not like, but that's the organization, not the players.
We're still in all. I can't.
You don't like Draymond?
Hey man, it's like this. I want them to get that ass knocked off this shit. And I'm stacking up my dollars too.
The only team I would be okay with them losing to being that.
How can I pick a team to be okay with? If a team beat them, they just beat them. You can't sit there and tell them what you'll be satisfied with. If they get beat by the Pelicans first round,
I want to see them win.
How about the Pelicans knock them off in the first round?
Pelicans knock them off in the first round, and that's on them.
Oh, but see, that ain't the team you want to see them get beat by.
I mean, well, no, it's like this. If they get beat, I really want to see OKC win. I want to see OKC win the championship this year, meaning that my team ain't got no dog and no damn fight other than the fucking draft lottery. Now, with that being said,
who is your team?
My team is the Lakers.
Oh, I don't even want to say that. I baited you.
I'm gonna stand up and I'm gonna take my lumps on the chin. You know what I'm saying? My team is the Lakers. We ain't got a dog in the fight, so therefore, all I'm gonna do is sit back and talk about everybody else's team. now, with that being said, like, I mean, what can you say to me? Yeah, my team sucks. Okay, and what? But anyway, what the hell was I just? What was I even just talking about? We was talking about, OKC. I want to see OKC win. I like Russell Westbrook was my favorite player in the league.
I know what I'm saying. He's my favorite player
in the league. And even Kobe had said in his little Muse documentary that I think it was either that or just a regular interview. He was saying that he feels like Russell Westbrook is the one he sees with the same killer instinct that he had, same killer instinct that Jordan had. You know what I'm saying? He says that Russell Westbrook is who he sees, you know, and I can see that, you know. Right. Russell take too much negative crap, you know, they take too much shit about him, about how much he shoots and all of that. But what I'm saying is, look, nowadays we in the era of the scoring point guard.
Right.
Not only that, but I mean, look, if you was that good, you would shoot too.
True
and
that.
KD still get his shots. KD still average more points than he does.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And he always does when he's healthy. So I don't see the big point of him taking the shots that he takes with everybody having a problem with it.
Oh, well, they definitely have a problem with it. But see, everybody, when you say everybody, it's not that. Well, I ain't going to say that because it is. I was going to say it ain't the average black person. Because there's a lot of us selling Russell Westbrook out.
Yeah.
I can hear him now in the barbershop last week. Oh, man, Russell Westbrook take too many shots. Oh, he passed the ball to him. He do this, he do that. But hold up. When KD got hurt, who almost carried that team to a distance?
To the playoffs. Yeah, you know, he almost took them to the playoffs. Russell Westbrook. He was an MVP candidate talk.
Mm. What about the Fitch? What about the Sixers, Fitch?
What about the Sixers?
That's from Bust to Bust for everybody don't know who wrote that chat right there. You know what I'm saying?
Just because the Sixers are the Sixers. They're an abomination of an organization right now. Ever since Dr. J left, and actually ever since AI left, it's just been downhill for them. So,
and they got rid of Ecuador.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Governor Vince Wright saying, B-Rabbit, nice job on the boards. The show sounds great. Seriously. Hey, man, B-Rabbit ain't over here doing this board over here. It's me and Jerzey on this board, Gov. Don't you today? Don't you come up on? Don't you? Hey, Gov, don't you come up in here? Don't you come up in here with your motherfucking toes out, talking about somebody running our boards? Me and Jerzey run the boards up in here. No disrespect to the Zen Master. You know what I'm saying? But come on, Gov, man, we ain't new to this. We true to this, baby.
That's right.
Oh, with you?
Yeah, shoot him again.
Take two more for your ass. Pause.
Yeah, pause. Yeah.
Anyway,
your 6'5", 345 pound ass. Pause.
He said he. Gum said he ducking. Gum said he ducking. Anyway, yeah, Gum, you know it's all love, baby. I just feel like Golden State is the best team in the league, Jerz.
Yeah.
You don't like them for, you know, for what they did to Mark Jackson. I understand that. But the players still show Mark Jackson love when they was on their championship run and he was there announcing the game. You know, and I just really feel like, you know, that's what he built. Let that team flourish for as long as we know that's Mark Jackson's team.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we can't hold that against them. Like, I like what he did with them. You know what I mean? He turned them around, put them in the right way. You know, they screwed them over.
Right.
But Mark Jackson is still, he still has a job, you know, and he's still going to get the coaching job that he deserves eventually. You know what I'm saying? He should have one now, but I think he's going to end up being the coach of Cleveland. I don't know if Tyronn Lue's going to work out or not. But
You know what? This young lady I know used to date Mark, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she lives here in the A. And me and her was talking about it. She said she don't think Mark want a job. She think that the job Mark had, the way they did him, it kind of like, you know, set him back a minute as far as teams in the NBA and all that, you know. So, hey, man, I don't know, man. You know, it's going to be wait and see, man, because it's going to be a lot of job openings next year.
Yeah.
You know, so we'll see.
But, I mean, what job do you think he would take? Like, I don't think he would take a job unless it was a team that was a contender, because for someone of his status, like, why would he go back to try to build up another team so that organization could do it in the same fucked up way, you know what I'm saying, that the Warriors did?
Yeah. We got a special alert is going out to Vince Wright, Sports Done Right, from the real cast architect, Jungle Brother. Jungle Brother says, Jerzey and Fish, you better warn Governor. I don't play fair. His wife is listening. That's the only reason why my gun ain't cocked. Uh-oh.
Hold on. We ain't gonna have none of that today, man. It's a beautiful Saturday.
Beautiful Saturday.
We ain't gonna have none of that today, man. Y'all, both of y'all fall back right now, man. Both of y'all fall back because from this moment on, y'all little tennis match, y'all not gonna play tennis and use me and Jerzey to be the ball. Pause. You know what I'm saying? So y'all can keep going back and forth. Y'all can keep going back and forth. When y'all going back and forth, while y'all going back and forth, we ain't gonna read that chat. You know what I'm saying? So right now, we are being the referees. You know what I'm saying? And we stepping in, or I'm stepping in. And I'm saying pause right now. Y'all can cut that out for a minute. All right? And they go, here go my gavel right here. Rah. All right, man. What we going to do right now, Jerz? I see that fucking, you see that car pulling up over there?
Yes, sir.
That can only mean one thing. I mean, our good friend is in the house. Oh, he's pulling up to the house.
Yes,
so we getting ready to interview our good friend, one of the best friends of our show. He's been down with us. He always come through, bless us with some gifts and all types of stuff. All of y'all who are new listeners, you'll find out who we talking about. And everybody who already knows, y'all already know who we talking about. We're going to take us a quick little break And after this break, we're going to come back and we will get into the interview with our good friend.
While you're burning up, I feel the breeze up the freeway.
Oh, Mary, baby, I
asked her, could I hit? There was nothing she could say.
Trust me, boo, I would never
let my Mary solitary confine. I find myself dealing with time. Now that she's dealing with time, dealing with time.
Yeah. Now I'm in love with this girl, and I never really told her, but I swear she know it cause of the way that I hold her. Don't care that I'm out in the street, stuck in the heat, cause she know the more I eat, then the more we meet, then the more I'm having sex with her. It's just the way she smells, her body aroma, I gotta be next to her. With money in my pockets, then I gotta be vexed with her. Mad when I can't touch, mad when I can't nudge. But no matter what, that's my shorty. She been there before the yak, the cracks, the jacks in the 40s. Love the fact I'm on wax, and they always recording me. She say she want me richer than Berry Gordy. Always with other dudes, so she don't mind when I cheat. Just make sure I wrap it up when I'm tapping them freaks. We went from hours to days, from days to weeks. Now I'm in love with this broad till I'm returning to sleep.
While you burning up, I feel the breeze up the freeway.
Ooh, Mary, baby, I
need you. I asked her, could I hit? There was nothing she could say.
Trust me, baby, I would never
let my Mary solitary confine. I find myself dealing with time. Now that she's dealing with time.
Ooh, Mary, baby, I need you. No matter how rough it get, I can never leave you. Our bond is real strong, like Freeway and Siegel. Even though just knowing you makes me illegal. And it ain't an age thing, dog, she older than me. She got some people calm, some colder than me. Got some people rich and others owing they peeps. And she real flammable, like oils and grease. Since I've been with her, dog, she done changed my life. Turn my lips the same color like white and rice. Let me know who is real and who real tripe. Can't front though, she done made me nice on the mic. It's like, the more I write, the more I recite. The more I spit, she keep dudes saying I'm tight. Broke up for 3 months once when we had a fight. Now I'ma stay with this chick until it's time to see the light.
You burning up, I feel the breeze up the freeway.
Ooh, Mary, baby, I
asked her, could I hit? There was nothing she could say.
I would never
let my Mary solitary confine. I find myself dealing with time. Now that she's dealing with time. Dealing with time.
Dealing with time. Just dealing with time. Stay on my mind.
Yes, yes, we're back. We're back. It's the Bottom to the Top show featuring Chief Rocker Jerzey Vern, the Microwave Patty Cake Patty Cake, Jon Fisher. We back here in the house, man. Like we said before we left, that we had a special guest coming in. This guy right here, man, he's more than a special guest, man. This guy brings us gifts. He's an NBA to be superstar. You know, right now he's shining. He got the third to fourth highest selling jersey in the NBA. My man, I want him to be y'all man, Kris Porzingis is in the house. What's up, Kris?
Hey, Jerzey Fisher. Always good to be in the house with friend. Every time Kris come, have good time with fellas, and if he dies, he dies.
Yeah, well, you know what, Kris, man? You know, the last time you was here talking to me in the microwave, you know, Jon Fisher, you know, which just ran to the bathroom. He'll be right back, you know, because I'm quite sure he got some questions for you. But, hey, man, tell everybody how we got down in New York, man, how we partied, man. You know, you had them girls, and, oh, man, that was just a gravy time, man. I love that.
Well, Jerzey, basically, what Kris want to do is show love. And I watch a well-stored hip-hop, and Kris learn American style in Latvia. And when Kris come to America, at Jerzey Fisher. Two friends of Kris always support Kris from when Nick draft Kris. Everyone want to boo Nick draft, but Jerzey Fisher say good pick.
That's right.
So Kris want to reach out to Jerzey Fisher and talk maybe a little bit, and next thing we become good friends.
Okay.
And when I bring you and Fisher to New York, I want my friend have good time. So I have the finest Latvian women in the world. I give 6 Latvian women to Jerzey, and I give 4 Latvian women to Fisher, because Jerzey seem like him handle more women than Fisher.
Yeah, man, you know me, man. Hey, tell them how when we's up there dancing, man, and Spike Lee song came on from school dance during the butt, you know, how the girls just circled around me, and I just went one at a time, man, just riding that booty, wasn't I?
Everyone, real cast, everyone listening, know, Jerzey Vern, how do you say Jerzey, cut rug?
Yeah, cut the
Jerzey rug. Vern like to cut rug, and every time Jerzey get dance floor, the women want to circle and dance with Jerzey, because Jerzey very, very, very smooth with the women, Latvian and American and Puerto Rican, and if they die, they die.
Hey, Kris, you know, you got a fan in the chat room, you know, you went on his show first until he started dogging you out. You got Jungle Brother in there, man, and he asked me to ask you, is you still taking good care of Spike Lee Lawn in the Hamptons?
Spike Lee, very good friend of Christoph, and Christoph take care of Spike Lee Lawn, and Christoph take care of Spike Lee's desires with Latvian women.
Yeah.
Very much take care of Spike Lee. Very good friend. Spike Lee like to shoot jump shot, like, yeah. Kris shoot jump shot.
Kris, before I finish this interview with you, man, we got a real cash range in the house. He goes by the name of Gary G Money Joyner, the Everyday People Show host star. Gary Joyner, what's going on, my son?
Jerzey, before the Fisher come, I want you see your gift. I want you see your gift before the Fisher.
Gift.
I bring Jerzey a nice New York Knicks chain. And Jerzey, you get Porzingis autographed jersey to hang in man cave. Also, I bring you box of Cuban cigar, Jerzey. You smoke cigar,
right? Yeah. I ain't never had a Cuban before.
Yes,
man.
Kris want to take care of friend very much, so I bring Jerzey a box Cuban cigar.
Wow, man, this is
where Fisher.
Oh, man,
Fisher coming?
Yeah, he coming. There you go. Yo, man, look at this here necklace, man, and the Jerzey Porzingis gave us, man.
Yo, Kris, what up, man?
Yeah.
Hold on. Jerz, what in the world did this dude just buy you, man?
Man.
A chain?
Yeah, man. Yeah, with a PM
Kris,
and diamonds.
Kris, like, you bought me a gift, Kris? Fisher, I bring gift for you special. I tell you right now, I open box. And paper, wrapping paper. Kris want to wrap. Fisher, Kris bring you a shelling leather coat, and the rest of your present will show up tonight, Fisher. Tonight? What you mean tonight? Fisher, the rest of your gift show up tonight. Maybe 11 o'clock, when you put kids to bed, your gift show up, and you have good time.
Oh, that sounds like a good gift for 11 o'clock tonight.
You kind of do, right? 11 o'clock?
Yeah. Man, I want to know what the fuck that is.
Kris, you're going to have to come back later on, man.
Shit.
I don't know, man. But Kris, anyway, man, we appreciate the fact that you always stayed in touch with us, even though, like, you started from the bottom. You kind of like us, you know. You started from the bottom, and now you're going to the top. People didn't agree with the Knicks drafting you with the number 4 pick, and you got booed. Everybody said this, everybody said that, but now you're flourishing as a rookie. Now, we know Gary G. Money Joyner still don't believe in you. He's out there in the chat room right now, I see. And but, Kris, like, just tell everybody, you know, how's it feel to be doing as well as you're doing? Did you expect that to happen, and did you think it would be this way? Well, Fisher, Christoph say, I always knew I play basketball and shoot jump shot. But when I come to America and play NBA, Kris never knew dunk on people so easy in NBA. I think because I watch well-starred hip-hop, I see people dunk, and Kris say, oh, Kris can't do that like that. But I come into league, and Kris put back dunk, and Kris shoot jump shot, and Kris play very well, and very happy to see success in NBA, Fisher.
Kris, stop. Tell me something. One of your haters out there, he got 3 questions for you. I'm going to run the 3 questions down, and you can answer them any way you want. The first question was, ask Porzingis, weak ass, had he reached out to Ewing to help him on non-existent low post game, which I disagree on that one. Number 2 was, Jerzey, look at the box. If it says made in Russia, it ain't Cubans. Oh, so he's trying to discourage that you don't know how to go get Cuban cigars and whatnot. He's trying to say you're going to fake me out.
I think Jungle Brother a little jealous of give Kris bring for Jerzey Vern.
Well, you know, you got jealousy all around. You know, Kris, jealousy runs all around, you know.
Well, if Jungle Brother want to be jealous, you know, Kris always like to say, Jerzey, if he dies, he dies.
That's it. If he dies, he dies. That's all. And then he go ask Kris why he only got 5 rebounds in the USA versus the world game. Tell him, you had what, 30 points?
Yes, Kris shoot many jump shots. Kris put many dunk. Kris shoot free throw. Kris already feel better than DeAndre Jordan. Maybe not dynamic like DeAndre, but Kris more versatile than DeAndre. Kris shoot jump shot, Kris shoot 3, Kris dunk the ball, Kris put back dunk, Kris shoot free throw, and Kris block shot. You see Kristoff block Russell Westbrook.
Yes, sir.
And I pin to glass and I say, Russell, if you die, you die.
No. Yeah.
Russell Westbrook, very good player, and best highlight Kristoff career so far, block Russell Westbrook.
Yeah, and I appreciate that, because that game y'all should have won. You know, you had them down at the end. But, you know, hey, man, you get back to that, you know what I'm saying? But, Kris, man, you know what? I am overwhelmed, and I appreciate the gifts you bring. You know, you sent in a private jet for me and the Michael Wade Fisher.
He sure did, didn't he? The
fly out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was ill, man.
You know, so, hey, man. You know, we can't do nothing, man. You bring tears in my eyes sometimes when you do some of the things you do, man. You know, and them 6 women, man, if y'all ain't never seen the women that Kris be around, well, y'all need to check out some of his YouTube.
Finest Latvian women in the world. Latvian women, real good women, take care of man, cook Latvian beef and Latvian food, and take care of man in every way. Don't want to get too vulgar, Jerzey, on show. But, right. Jerzey, you know they say well-starred hip-hop, real recognize real.
Right.
And Kris recognize Fisher, Jerzey, very real, and keep it real with Kris. So, Kris want to show love back when Kris do good, because when Kris did not do bad, but Kris get boo.
Why?
You two stick with Kris, so Kris want to stick with the Jerzey Fish.
That's right. And we're going to be with you, Kris. And we always love you coming by, stopping by, man. I mean, to make a special trip here to Atlanta to see us, man, whenever we having a show, man, I mean, you just come out the blue and say, Chief Rocker, what you doing today? I told him, hey, man, I'm having a show, man. You know, I know you ain't going to be able to make it. Dog, stop. I'm going to talk like you, Chris. Stop. Chris Stark can do anything he want to do.
Yeah, he does say that.
You know, and he just come by and check us out, man.
Well, Jerzey, because you good friend and Fisher good friend want to help any way Chris can to help show get to money status and you get sponsored, Jerzey, and Fisher. Chris want to show love in any way because you always show love to Chris. And maybe Chris bring one you. You like that dirt bike? Just drive by.
Well, you know,
Chris, I do. I know I do, Chris.
I'm not a dirt bike man. I don't like motorcycles, Chris. But you can get the microwave, you know.
Well, shit. Chris buy microwave. Maybe Chris buy one dirt bike for you and a microwave junior. I hear he's back to healthy and want to do gift for him too. So maybe Chris do something for you and. Jerzey, Chris has special gift for you when yeah. that happened.
Well, Chris, you know what? Before we let you go, I got a couple of questions that's coming out here, man. Seems like everybody's on the Chris Stock bandwagon in the chat. Jungle Brother said Emmanuel Mouillet had 3 rebounds. Porzingis usually got at least 10 more than that. I don't agree. Jungle Brother says I'm watching the girl. His Tar Heels bouncing back. You know, yeah. But, okay, Jungle Brother said, ask Chris why he did not call a press conference denouncing the firing of Derek Fisher. Gary G. Money Joyner said, Chris Stock got to get more rebound.
Wait.
Should
wait.
He always average double figures? He's Fisher? Freaking shooting, he's freaking 7'3".
Chris will say this, Jerzey, and Fisher, and traitor Jungle Brother, Derek Fisher, very good friend, Kristaps, but the locker room start to rumble because Fisher like to sleep with women. And Fisher not relate to you? Nah, I ain't related to him. I wish I was because he got that dope. Well, Fisher was very good friend to Chris. We have very good time. But Kristaps, only rookie, never can say anything but Nick Fire coach. Kristaps not in position to say anything reference to Coach Fire.
Yeah, yeah. Michael Wayne, what's that ninja said about Chris?
Look like Diplomat say, hey, Kristaps, stop stealing my swag. Sign Dolph Lundgren. Oh man, Chris, he kind of getting on you, man. It was a good one though. You know, yeah. It was a good one though. Chris, what you got to say about that? Dolph Lundgren, Kristaps' favorite actor. So when Chris 15 years old, I take in phrase, if he dies, he dies, because Chris think that stupid American people will like Chris to say, if he dies, he dies. So Chris want to say that to make everyone think Chris just stupid. But Jerzey and Fish know Chris not stupid, and Chris have very good Latvian food and women.
I got something for you, Michael Way.
What's up?
Your favorite buddy out there, Jungle Brother said, Chief Rocket, tell Fisher to back, fall back while you conducting this interview.
Hey, man, Jungle, man, you stand back. Well, you know, I ain't even going to give Jungle no leeway because we over here trying to talk to Chris. Jungle just trying to find a way to steal the damn show. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But, Jungle, you fall back. You fall back. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I ain't been saying much. I already know. You know what I'm saying? Chris get Jerzey the better, you know, the better gifts and all that. And that's cool because Jerzey, you know, Jerzey got sent Rorty around this motherfucker with Chris. So I ain't worried about nothing. Chris is my man. Jerzey got the interview, but this my show too, so I'm going to speak.
That's right. This the bottom to the top show. You know what I'm saying? It's under the leadership of two great guys and a great basketball player to be. You know, when this guy right here start ringing out championships, I want everybody that's in the chat room, to respect what Kris Porzingis is doing, you know. But anyway, Kris, you know, we got some more people we need to talk to.
Yes. Kris must get back to New York and get ready for the game. Kris must go, but want to come say hi to friends. So appreciate yes, everything. Yeah, Fisher Jerzey. The next time Kris come with more gift because Kris have money to blow. That Drake say? Money to blow.
Money to blow.
Money to
money
blow.
Blow. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So, Jungle Brother asked Kris Doc why he's only scoring 9 points out of 30 inch in the Wonder League pre-draft interview. Kris said, and I'm going to answer this for him, when you get 6 points in the Wonder Link, then you can talk to him. He said, you only, it's like a three below the average of what you need to be. So Kris said he ain't got time for that. But anyway, Kris, man, yo, man, good thing.
Yes, Jerzey.
We're about to go to a break so we can walk Kris down to the limo. And
see you the next time. Peace out to RealCast family.
Yeah, nigga.
Yeah.
Sound room in the building.
Yeah.
My name Dread. My close niggas call me Dree. You soon to hear me with Biz, the same OGs. I'm Sour Diesel and you, the same old trees. You 6 months hustling, the same old trees. I've been on the block faithfully, baby. Every now and then the fiends catch a break from me, baby. Focused on rap, I done made me a baby. Haters want me clap, mama pray for your baby. Oh, I'm all real, dog, I don't fuck around with clowns. Ask around, walk through my stomping ground. Wanna sing a nigga, tell you nigga Dread push. Making moves on the field like Reggie Bush. I'm too fucking ill, what the fuck you gonna tell me? More than Columbia Coke, nigga, sell me. Name Dread, but my close friends call me Dreeze. As both of 16, knock you out your dungarees.
Yeah, knock him out, nigga. Yeah, it's Jay Diggs, nigga. I start blacking like I'm back in the booth. These niggas lacking the truth. They born a few, still attacking a few. But I just listen, I ain't rapping with you. I got a crew. So I can give a fuck what you happen to do. Make it tonight, I ain't rapping, I be clapping at you.
That's right.
I show you what your calibers do. Knock them days off your calendars, dude. You and the days can't handle the dude. My foul ways from a challenging you. But now I'm older, a lot bolder, trying to balance the truth. You see a bold, you know I'm holding, I ain't battling you. My main thing is to earn these chips. Be my seeds, spit flames like a work of a bitch. Smoke weed, proceed, get to work in the fifth. A calm dude will slip quick, dirt for girt in this bitch.
I let you niggas know that I'm so anxious. The shit is genuine when you meet with the stainless. And I keep the mask so I stay changing faces. All about the cash so I stay serving aces. The clip be on blast so you best to roll out. My dro mixed with hash, I'm about to fall out. I drink yak straight, motherfucker, no doubt. Pressure bust pipe, some niggas take the whole route. I get paid off the street so I can't hold out. I flame on the beat, I'm what the chat is about. Yeah, make this shit happen in the action like Jackson. Faz on a bitch who be steadily yapping. I'm about business strictly. Pass me the icky. Hand me the mag so I can load these blickies. Hand you your asshole. Give you what you ask for. Pump us with the black fork. Come on and get with me. With the 357, was a 187. Resorting the 211s. Keep the steel on reserve. Is it hell or heaven? Talk it out with the reverend. You get hit with the weapon. You don't follow my word. Backwards from the movie. I got a green crust. To live in the focus. I can never have enough. I put it down, bitch, and my flow getting tough. If I pick it up, bitch, then you all get in touch.
What?
Hey, we G-Lo, all in this motherfucker, man.
You already heard us.
D-Crack.
Hey, man.
Why? This is
what we do, dog.
D-Twist.
What we do, man?
Down room, motherfucker.
What up, P? Good looking.
You
thank
you. This shit,
we appreciate that shit, man.
What up?
Yeah, we're back, the bottom to the top show here on a beautiful Saturday down in ATL. I am the Chief Rock of Jerzey Vern with my partner, Patty K, Microwave, Jon Fisher. Listen, man, when it rains, it pours, man. We just came into the house. My girl, Jon Fisher's grandmother, Grandma Eunice, is up in this piece right here. What's up, Grandma?
Hello. Hello, Jerzey, my friend. Jerzey, my friend.
What's up, Grandma?
How you doing? How you doing, Jerzey Vern?
Oh, I'm lovely, you know what I'm saying? You looking good today?
Thank you.
Got your flower dress on.
Thank you. Yeah. I want to come on and look a little pretty today because a good weather outside in the winter day in Atlanta. So Grandma Eunice want to look a little nice for Uno Jerzey.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, anytime you come up in the house, you looking good to me, Grandma, you know what I'm saying? You know, Fisher got a pretty long grandma, you know what I'm saying?
Thank you.
Yeah, by the way, Jon Fisher went there to get a slice of pizza, you know, pizza man came, you know. I guess he had to go in there and put a little grub in his stomach, you know, and whatnot from that, that apple, what's that, apple crown? Shit, you know. But anyway, Grandma, how you been feeling these days? I heard old man Cuddy been kind of bothering you up there, up in the spot. What's going on with that?
Well, Jerzey, the whole man Cuddy, him used to harass me all the time and me tell my grandson and me say, boy, you need to get this man for come and keep mess with me bomba. And I don't know why the boy want to have the same house with him and but me talk to my grandson and my grandson go on and pay a couple goon them for beat up Cutty them. And then them squash everything and now Cutty is fine, him now want disrespect grandma no more.
Oh, okay. See, I didn't hear that part of the story, Grandma. Because I talk to Cuddy every day, you know, on the chat, on different shows. And Cuddy tried to say that a lot of goons was always bothering him because you sicking them on him, you know. But you seem to be a sweet young lady to me. You know what I'm saying? What did he get that from?
No, I don't know where him get the story for that goon them thing. But Grandma Eunice never hurts anything and anyone. Because I love everybody, Jerzey, and, but me can't speak for my grandson, so me don't know what my grandson fi do with goon them a thing, but what my grandson do, Grandma Eunice don't know, so if something happened to the boy deserve the thing them, but Grandma Eunice don't have nothing fi do with that.
Right, and I see you had your Bible, so you're a very religious type young lady.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah. Give praises and thanks to Jesus Christ every morning and if I wake up.
Right. So, Eunice, what you think about me and your grandson's show? You know, the bottom to the top. You know, we finally getting together. This is the first time I've seen you in a minute, you know.
The boy not out here right now, so me tell you, don't tell the boy, me tell you this, Jerzey. Me like on a show better than when the boy talk by himself because the boy sometimes have a gap in him talk and, you know, me like Jerzey and me think the show run a lot smoother there and you one of the people them for keep the boy out of trouble. So me like when Uno for come around because you can't keep the boy out of trouble and keep him straight and him have fun.
Right. And you know what, Eunice, you know who I see in the chat room? You know, I see this old man go by the name of Cuddy, you know, with the nose like a Holland tunnel.
You can't block that, man.
No, we can't block him right now. We try not to do that, right? Yeah, but he said,
don't like that boy sometime, you know.
Yeah, you know what he had nerve to say? He said, Chief Rocker, she's been sicking those goons on me. She snitched and had them breaking my crap game. Oh, okay.
Lie to Mattel. Grandma Eunice plays CeeLo every night.
Uh-huh.
You know for play CeeLo, Jerzey,
because
you from a Jersey them.
Yeah.
Grandma Eunice plays CeeLo and the old man cut to them want to come and play in the game and then want to pay with food stamp. I said, no, you can't play with food stamp because we play with real money over here. Real thing this.
Yeah, real money.
And
yeah.
The boy want to go out and tell the administrator them that we are playing dice game.
Oh, you mean Cuddy is ratting on
Cuddy go off and tell the people that we play dice game and we want to let them play.
What?
Cuddy tell them people that.
Man, shoot. I thought Cudi had more charisma than that to be a snake, a fink.
No, Cudi done. Me not like that youth. Me tell you them.
Right.
Me not like that youth because the youth them are sneaky them.
Wow. But hold up, Grandma Eunice. We have a celebrity in the house on our own. We have Miss Thorny Switch up in the house on a Saturday. That's right, Thorny. We coming to you live today. And we would like to give you this special announcement.
Yes, me like my grandson for talk about Thorny Switch them.
Yeah.
And say him call Queen Thorny them. So, hello, Queen Thorny Switch. Hello, how you do?
Yes, she's saying hi to everybody, but Thorny, Grandma Eunice said how you doing, and she like you're one of the originals, and she wished that one day her grandson can find someone like you.
Jerzey, man, why the hell you let her get on the damn mic, Jerzey?
Amen.
Jerzey, come on, man, why you let her get on the mic?
Hey, man, well, you know, Grandma Eunice just wanted to say hello.
Man, I'm just trying to get a slice of pizza, man. You let this lady get on. What'd she say?
Man, she just was...
She said,
why? Don't talk to me. Why?
Granny, please, let's go in the house. Let's go in the house, Granny. Can you do that? We trying to do something over here. Jerzey, tell her to go in the house, man.
We'll talk to you later, Eunice. I'll be in there a little later to see you, you know.
Well, if you suggest, Jerzey, maybe Granny if you go on and go on and drink a little bit. Come back and see me a little later then.
Oh, yeah, I'll be by before I leave out of here.
Bye-bye, everybody. Grandma Eunice love everyone.
Yes, and this is the Bottom to the Top show here on this Saturday with the Chief Rocker Jerzey Vern and the Michael Wade Patty Cake, Jon Fisher. Yeah, we just had Jon Fisher grandmother stop up in here while he went and ate a slice of pizza.
No, why you let her get on
the air, man, she was entertaining, man. I'm quite sure everybody out there, you know, was loving Eunice, you know what I'm saying, and whatnot. And then we got people like Vince Wright talking about somebody tapping grandma. Ain't that something?
Oh, man.
What you gonna do about that, man?
God, man, ain't none of my business, man. I ain't none of my business, man. If Jerzey want to venture down them avenues, that's on Jerzey. Yeah. All I know is I'll be a beneficiary. You know what I'm saying? Jerzey, Grandma Eunice kind of old, man.
Well, you know,
I don't think Jerzey want none of that, man.
No, you know, that's Vince, man. You know, he was wishing he was close around so he can tap a little something. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
LOL, Vince. LOL. Yeah, man. So what we got going on right now, Michael Wade?
We ain't get a chance to talk about Peyton Manning and Archie Manning since the story came out. Now, I know everybody out there, y'all been hearing about Peyton all week, you know, but myself cooking with the microwave, I spoke about it last Sunday on last Sunday's show. But I did want to get a chance to bounce it off you, Jerzey, like, and you tell me what you feel about this whole Peyton Manning stuff. Now, this is going to be a little bit vulgar, so this is explicit content, TVMA, or should I say RD, radio MA, RDMA, whatever you want to say. But Peyton Manning was accused, I think it was in 98, of rubbing his nuts and asshole on this lady, Dr. Jamie Norwright's face. And it was all type of cover-ups going on, Jerzey. First, before we get into any type of facts, man, I just want to hear your thoughts on what you know about it. If you know, I know you've heard about it by now.
Well, back in the days, man, you know, when we done Two Live Stools tailgate, you know, I ran into, Chuck Smith used to come down
to the Stools.
Yeah, Chuck Smith used to come down there and to the tailgate, one of the best tailgates in Atlanta Falcon history down there. The Two Live Stools tailgate was like another dimension, you know. But anyway, I used to talk to Chuck about Tennessee, you know, how it was out there playing and all that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And during that time, he always used to say, you know, people that was kind of wild. And, you know, Peyton names used to come up. And I was like, Peyton?
Really?
Yeah, I used to be like, Peyton seemed like he was a weirdo, you know what I'm saying? You know, like a little country hick, you know? But I never questioned him what he meant about that. And now that all this is coming out, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of like, Chuck wanted to get something off his back then.
Yeah.
And I should have ventured more into it. But being back then, man, I was about drinking and, you know, the women and, you know, whatever else happening down at the tailgate. That's what I was about, you
yeah.
know. But now that you asked him this question, what I think about it, and I said yesterday on my show that I came on for an hour,
uh-huh.
you know, I'm back, Jersey's back.
What's the name of that show?
Oh, my show was Chief Rock and Jerzey Vern Recap Show. But, you know, okay. when I come on during the week, besides on a Monday,
uh-huh.
you know, I may have a little title here or there.
Okay.
But it's always going to be on recapping something.
Got you.
You know, but when I came on yesterday, I said, this guy, Sean King, has opened up the biggest can of whoop ass. You know, people say they open a can of worms. He opened up the biggest can of whoop ass. And what I mean by whoop ass, that's giving every media outlet besides the Gentile the situation of jumping on Peyton Manning. Because Peyton Manning think he's the golden boy. He think he's a person that should never had nothing bad said about him. When he's going around, like Buster said the other day in the chat room, Peyton Manning is out here. He was out there in college just taking snacks from everybody. You know? He was the man that was considered the bully amongst women. You know? And that's kind of big and harsh to say, but that's what he was doing. He was bullying women back in the days and doing what he wanted to do, you know. And if you look at him, he looked like he's that sneaky type of person that when he gets mad, he do things like that, you know. I don't know if the man drink, what he do, what was his history as far as drinking, but if he did drink and the way he makes himself feel as far as being the king, they say he was down in Tennessee acting like he was the king of the campus. At
well,
time.
Yeah, he probably was. I mean, he kind of helped resurrect the football program and all of that stuff. And apparently, I think what the story might be saying is, like, she had accused him of, like, cheating. I don't know if it was on a test or a paper or whatever the case may be, but she accused him of cheating, and there was already some bad blood between the two, which is pretty much what led to the incident that happened in, I think it was 98. Yeah, it had to be 98 when, you know, she's accusing him of doing that. She immediately went to the sexual assault crisis hotline and all that other stuff. But, like, what about the dude, like, the you know, Mike Rolo, he was telling her, well, let's say it was a black player, you know what I'm saying? And even furthermore, Archie Manning in the book was acting like, oh, yeah, well, she used to go around and sleep with the black players. Like, he made it seem like it was something filthy if she was going around sleeping with black players or something.
And see, this is my thing, right? They try to discredit her. She probably don't even like black players. You know, she probably don't even like a black man, period. But they want to try to discredit her. And why is it always the black man? Why not the Mexican? Why not the Filipino? You know, why not?
Because we the most despicable things that, you know, they can probably bring home to their family.
I mean, it's always give it to the black man, you know? You know what I'm saying?
You're saying black man did as society believes. You know what I mean? But aside from that, like, the, you know how they say, Jerz, the cover-up is worse than a crime? You know what I'm saying? And I don't know. I mean, I guess technically this could have been called a sexual assault back at the time. Everything got settled out of court. And then Peyton Manning and them went and spoke about it in the book. Now, they didn't name her in the book, but they pretty much was insinuating her in the book. You know what I'm saying? And I just don't understand, like, how people can't see that this is really an issue.
First of all, that shows he's not very intelligent, because if it's something that you was covering up, why would you even write a book and throw something like that in it? You ain't got nothing else to talk about? That's my thing. You know, so that makes me think that they think people out here are stupid.
Yeah.
And they're the smartest things or the smartest people out here in this world. But to me, they lacking a lot of smartness, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm like this, man. Whatever happened to Peyton Manning, he deserved, you know.
And I mean, but what can, like, here's the thing. he can't go to jail. Like, everything that is involving Peyton Manning and Dr. Jamie Norwright has all been settled. The only reason it's coming back up now is because there's another class action suit going against the University of Tennessee in which that incident is stated. And they're trying to say that Tennessee had created an institution that kind of harbors sexual assault. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know you heard about the stuff that's going on at Baylor that have been covered up and all that stuff, too.
Right.
So that's pretty much what they're saying is that, okay, hey, look, the University of Tennessee kind of covers up this type of activity. Mm-hmm. And Peyton Manning's case was named in that. But he can't face any jail time, and there's really nothing the NFL can do about it. Like, so Peyton Manning is pretty much good, like, at the very least, what? He loses endorsements? He done already caked up?
That's what I'm talking about. I mean, I know jail time wasn't in the equation, mm-hmm. but as far as everything, the little car commercial, the little other stupid commercials he made, you know what I'm saying? The pizza commercial, you know?
Yeah,
all that, I want him to lose. Because you know why? If it was a brother, they would be trying to put him in jail, and they know they can't put him in jail. So that's what I'm talking
about.
The
funny thing about it, though, Jerz, if it was a brother, you know what I'm saying? Had that been Jameis Winston?
Right.
You see how they crucified Jameis.
For some,
you know what I'm saying? And even with the girl, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, Jameis Winston was a topic of discussion for what? Months at a time. Dog, I was in a bar on draft day, and it was primarily white people in the bar. You know what I'm saying? I'm in a bar on draft day, and people is literally booing Jameis Winston getting drafted number one overall and calling him a rapist. You know what I'm saying? But people like, you know, Ben Roethlisberger, Johnny Manziel for his discretions. You know, who the hell are we talking about right now?
Brett Favre. He did some silly shit.
Brett Favre with the little text message. You know what I'm saying? Now Peyton Manning, like, the stories don't get covered as much. They don't get as much airtime as if it was, you know, somebody who was black. And it's not always the case, but it's, I would say, 9.9 times out of 10, that's the case. You know what I'm saying? I just don't understand, like, okay, like, for the same reason, like, they say, okay, Johnny Manziel needs help. You know what I mean? But when it's, you know, Ray Rice, Adrian Peterson, Ray McDonald, you know, they're like, oh, these guys are thugs, let's get them out of the league.
Yeah, yeah. And see, that's the sad part about it. You know, it's always get us out the league. But it's always protect them so they can keep the face of the league. You know? I don't understand.
Governor says, now watch how much coverage Cam smoking weed last night is going to get. Cam who? Cam Newton?
I didn't hear about that one. Vince, you got
Cam who? Cam Newton or Cam Chancellor? Well, Cam Chancellor spelled with a K. Cam was smoking weed last night and got caught on tape. What's up, Gov? Let us know in the chat room. But anyway, outside of that, we'll keep it moving. But yeah, man, Jerzey, like, the narrative is just, like, so much different from one to the other. Like, they literally raked Jameis through the coals, man.
Yeah, I didn't like that whole situation with Jameis Winston. First of all, as far as the girl, you know, we don't know about that unless you was there, you know. So what they put out there is the campus and the Gentile news reporters putting it out there. But as far as the crab legs, they blew that out of proportion due to the fact that the store owner always gave his favorite football players the opportunity to take whatever they want to take. Because he know that they don't get to eat on a regular basis. You only ate when it was mealtime on the campus, you know. And if you got an apartment and you ain't got that much money, you know, he would feed the football players. So as far as people going around talking about he stole crabs and all that, that didn't even sound right, man. Because when I went to school, football players used to go to stores and get whatever they want. And the store owner.
Yeah, they get hookup.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much was a, you know, just like the Peter Warwick situation. Like Peter Warwick, it was a hookup gone wrong, and they suspended the dude. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
For getting a, like, you suspend him for getting a hookup from somebody else, and it's just crazy how stuff like that happens. But then when it's Peyton Manning in situations, everything gets swept under the rug. You know, it's a settlement here, sign with a confidentiality agreement. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
so where
right.
as the person who's accusing him of it can't, by accepting whatever, you know, it was,
right.
by accepting the terms, you are not allowed to speak about this. And then they turn around and violate that agreement, get a defamation suit filed against them, and then that gets settled out of court again with another confidentiality agreement.
Wow.
You know, so like, wow. and so what people don't understand is like, the person who is accusing them of this stuff, she's not the one that's bringing this back up.
Right.
So, you know, everyone would criticize Sean King of the New York Daily News for bringing this out and all that stuff, saying that he got an agenda that makes it look like he's just trying to back Cam up and all of that stuff. Even if he was, so what?
Yeah. Because so what?
What he's trying to say is, this stuff is going on right now, it's getting swept under the rug, but y'all worried about Cam Newton and his press conference. You know what I'm saying? Like, priorities. Where do your priorities lie? You worried about Cam Newton and his press conference. Meanwhile, Peyton Manning has been named in a lawsuit, in a class action lawsuit against the University of Tennessee.
Wow. Yeah. You know, well, you know how they do, man. You know? You can't win with the bullshit. And,
yeah.
and that's just exactly what it is. It's the bullshit. You know?
Yeah. Well, anyway, y'all. We're going to take us our last little quick break, and we're going to come back, finish out the show. Let me get y'all something good queued up. What I play first? All right. We're going to hit y'all with some Size Them Up, some of my mixtape stuff from back in the day. We'll be back. We're going to do our last little segment, close the show out. You listen to the Bottom to the Top show. And we're getting some more of y'all chat room popping. So y'all get the chat jumping off while we on break. And then we'll be able to jump into the chat room as well.
Mama say I'm hood and I ain't never going change. As cool as long the fact remains, I never been a lane. Never stayed up on the block like it was never going rain. And when it did, I still posted like the shit never came.
Never.
You niggas rocking with Dreezy the youngin'. If a nigga wanna see me, I'm immediately dumping. Got hot cause the rocks and the trees I was bumping. Surprised they kicked down the door and it was me that they cuffin'. Bust nothing, I ain't frontin', catch a case, be the case. And the streets is like the same, catch a fake, be the snake. Rock the eight balls and quarters, but I really wanted weight and hustle in the first place, cause I really need a plate, feel me? I know this nigga's out this bitch that wanna kill me, but if I wanna have these pussies make the news daily, them little death threats make me cautious, they don't scare me. This nigga talk good, but do you back it up, barely? You ain't seeing trees, seeing things, seeing shit. You ain't seeing night, seeing ice, seeing weeds. Go somewhere, get a beer, nigga, smoke your weed. But be aware, if I squeeze, then you gon' bleed. I drink yak straight and bud on the regular. The gat gon' quake and send eight to your juggler. Started on my hustle, they call me a snow shoveler. Made the D's believe I was a key smuggler.
Swerving in my suburban, the choppers block a blocker, the choppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban, I'm on swerve, swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban, the choppers block a blocker, the choppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban, I'm on swerve. Riding through the city, dirty money like Diddy. Got a bad chick with me, she want me to stroke a kitty. That Kush smoke got me on the highway doing 50 plus your boy on swerve. Like I want the cops to get me, baby girl on the road. Say she like the way I do things, nickname me Staircase. Stepping up my shoe game, slide to the nudie bar, put a couple stacks on it. Find a hotel bed, put a couple backs on it. I'm on swerve, I'm on swerve at the drive-thru. Try and keep my tires off the curb. Already told you, with
swagger, we stepping, got the shorty on your arm, looking at my retro sevens, but that get you quite offended. You look at me with ice grill, I ain't sweating you, dog, I'm higher than a light bill. So keep it easy with the mood swings. Sucker knuckles, tripping, no shoestrings. Who bang? Swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. The chopper's blocker, blocker. The coppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. I'm on. I'm on swerve. Swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. The chopper's blocker, blocker. The coppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. I'm on. In the club with my mans, got a drink in each hand. Mommy busting it open, all a boy can say is damn. But she came with her girls, put them on with the homies. Get a little sweaty, grab a bite at the Shoney's. Swerving my suburban, I got a few bottles. So rockin' cranberry and I'm stepping on the throttle. Inhale the perp, ooh yeah, like Randy Savage. These chumps hating on me cause they smoking on the average. Fresh pair Air Max, brand new fitted. You saying something about money, then nigga, let's get it. You saying something about honey, then nigga, I'm trying to hit it. They used to call me Dread, I cut my hair like Exhibit. Now I'm just Dreeze, bagging shorties with ease. Hit the mall, time to ball, I'ma blow a little cheese. Rolling with my G's, and we wish a nigga would. Want some choppers, blocka, blocka, there be mirrors in your hood. Cause I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. The choppers, blocka, blocka, the coppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. I'm on, I'm on swerve. Swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. The choppers, blocka, blocka, the coppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. I'm on, I'm swerving my suburban. The choppers blocka blocka, the coppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. I'm on, I'm on swerve. Swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. The choppers blocka blocka, the coppers gon' try and knock us when I'm swerving my suburban, swerving in my suburban. I'm on.
All right, everybody. We back. We got a little slight issue going on. I had some food a while ago, and I ain't get my food yet. So I'm waiting on these folks over here to bring me my food. So at any given time during this next little segment, I might have to pause it and start cussing these folks out for not having my food in me for about 2 hours. But anyway, we gonna do the quick hitter segment. That me and Jerzey like to do. And we gonna get it popping, man. You ready, Jerz?
Yes, sir.
Alright, so I'm gonna name a team in the NBA, and you gonna tell me how you feel about them, depending on the team. You can elaborate, or we'll just keep it moving when it's obvious. You ready?
Go ahead.
Alright, Chicago.
Squeaky.
Orlando.
Garbage.
Phoenix.
Garbage.
Charlotte.
Up and coming, but really don't have the firepower because their big man is out.
Brooklyn.
Oh man, Brooklyn is in the dumps.
Sacramento.
Sacramento is Marcus Cousins.
Memphis.
Memphis is going to surprise people in the playoffs. They're not going to get to the championship round, but they're going to surprise their first opponent.
We were saying that the last couple of years, they just can't get there, right?
They can't get there, man.
All right, moving along, we'll say Portland.
Portland is about to make that move.
New York.
New York is just proving people that they're not the team of last year. We need a point guard bad. We got two guys in the D League we picked up off of waivers. What's his name? What I told you, the name of Jimmy Fredette, and another cat, man. Ivan somebody.
Ivan Johnson?
No, it's Bagley or something like that.
Allen Johnson's out.
Yeah, Ivan Bagley or something like that. Both of them on the D League team running right now. Jimmy was lights out last night in the D-League. But until the Knicks get that firepower at the point guard, man, we're just going to be up and down right now.
All right. Toronto.
Toronto is the beast.
Atlanta.
Atlanta. Wait till next year.
San Antonio.
San Antonio may be the Western champions this year.
Lakers.
Garbage.
Clippers.
Clippers, too many head problems.
Minnesota.
Oh, man, Minnesota need to go and get some firewood and start that fire, man, because there's a fire sale about to go on up in there.
Detroit.
Detroit will never be the bad boys, and they just got too many holes.
Milwaukee.
Milwaukee's a young, interesting team. I don't know what's going on with Jason Kidd and the team this year, but last year they surprised a lot of people in the playoff. So I'm hoping they get that fire back, but
Dallas.
Dallas is always going to be Dallas. Jaminski and Cuban. That's all. They ain't going to never do nothing.
OKC.
OKC, if they stay healthy, they're going to make that West very interesting.
And Cleveland.
Cleveland going to do what Cleveland do, man. They're going to make it to that Eastern Conference Championship. Mm-hmm. And if the team ain't ready for them, they're going to win it.
Boston.
Boston is a surprise team. They're playing good ball, but they don't have enough firepower to make a move.
Miami.
Dwayne Wayne, as long as he go, Miami goes. But by Chris Bosh is back sick again.
He is?
Yeah, they're up and down.
Philadelphia.
Oh, man, shoot. Philadelphia might as well join Minnesota and start chopping some wood, man. Because there's a fire sale going on there, too.
Golden State.
Well, they want the record. But they couldn't prove it to me last night that they want that record.
Mm-hmm.
Because if they take another one of those type of games, they're going to start losing a little confidence in themselves. They'll make the playoffs and do something in the playoffs. But I'm telling you, if they're not ready for San Antonio, OKC, they're going to lose that championship ring this year.
Hey, we leave anybody out? I know we left a few. Minnesota. I said Minnesota. You said Minnesota already. Y'all leave anybody out? Or did we go through all 30 already?
Oh.
We couldn't have, right?
No.
Is anybody? Oh, Houston.
Oh, Houston got problems, man. Whenever, see, that's a lot of teams' problem. Whenever you're trying to get rid of a player that's a baby, when it comes back to playing, that player is going to try to take initiative among themselves to do whatever they want to do and forget the team.
Mm-hmm.
So Houston got a couple of problems. It's going to be between the White Hound and the Bid who control that ball the second half of the season.
Jungle Brother says, what about my Knicks?
We already spoke on them.
I thought we did we not?
Yeah.
Grego said, what's wrong with David Lee? Does he suck? David Lee doesn't suck. But in the day and age now where you're looking for a stretch four, David Lee is not really a stretch four. He can shoot a little bit, but he can't shoot any threes. He's not going to give you, you know, any like 20 footers or nothing like that. And at the same time, like, his defense isn't good at all. So he'll get you points and rebounds, But at the same time, he's not going to, you know, lock down anybody. He, you know,
He got traded.
Yeah, he got traded to Boston, and then he got waived by Boston. And then they're saying they're expecting him to sign with Dallas after he clears waivers.
Wow. Really?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, I guess that little bit of championship play he did last year don't really mean nothing. That brought you back to Mark Jackson build a good team around Curry and Klay Thompson.
Yeah.
Draymond Green. You know?
Yeah.
So that's the nucleus right there. You know, and they just got a good bench, man.
I mean, the Warriors to me are just like a so deep because they have it on so many levels.
Let's talk about the Knicks again. We already talked about it one time. Let's talk about it one time.
Let's talk about the Knicks.
All right. I watched the Knicks game last night, being that that's my team. And they played Brooklyn last night. And I've been preaching this all along. If we don't get a point guard, the Knicks is going to be a better team than they was last year, but they're going to be a team that can't get over that hump this year. All right, we went and picked up two guys off a waiver. Jimmy Fournette, he went down to the D-League last night shooting lights out, but, you know, he should because he's a D-League player. And we picked up a guy named Ivan Bagley. I don't know what's his status or what he does or whatever, but he's down in the D League too. So we're trying to shore up two positions to try to help us move on. But like I was telling my co-host, the Microwave, the Knicks are just going to be a better team than they was last year because we really need a point guard. And last night proved it because our point guard had 10 turnovers, and you cannot win a game turning the ball over when you're supposed to be the orchestrator of the offense. So that's the problem with the Knicks right now. We're not going to do nothing. And Moulier ain't the answer because Moulier ain't doing nothing with Denver, Jungle Brother. If Moulier was all that, Denver would have a better team. And Denver is playing around the 500 mark. You know, they're trying to get in the playoff, which they won't get in the playoff. So it ain't just about Moulier. Because I think Porzingis is doing a good job. And if he wasn't doing a good job, he wouldn't be playing as much as he's playing. So you cannot blame Porzingis for the Knicks' problems. And you can't say Moulier would have made him a better person because I look at it like this. The boy Galloway that they had, if he knew how to be a point guard instead of wanting to shoot all the time, he would be the answer. But he wants to shoot, and he has a great shot, so you can't take that away from him. But the Knicks will be back. They'll be back next year. If they sneak in the playoff this year, that'll be a plus for us, which they can do, make the playoff, if they get consistent point guard play. So I look at it like this. We will be back. We will be a better team. And Melo has two more years. And Melo said last night in the interview that he don't plan on going away. He want to see the growth of Porzingis get better. And he going to stay there and help him get better. And we will make the playoffs next year. So, you know, as far as all that about Moutier can't even carry my jock, all right? You talking about carrying somebody's job. He can't even carry my job, you know. If Moutier was all that, Denver would be in the top five in the West, and they're not. They ain't even the top eight. All right? Let me see what the chat's saying. Gary Joyner said, they said the Knicks going to be up and down until they get a legitimate point guard. Yeah, that's what I was saying, Gary. Jungle Brother said, tell Jerzey spit the sugar daddies out of his mouth. Jungle Brother said, I agree, G-Money. They should have drafted Moulier. I don't agree. Gary G-Money says, Moutier is a nudist.
Jungle said Denver don't have enough talent for Moutier to carry them, Chief. Okay, all right. So what makes you think he would have carried the Knicks then? You answered your own question. The Knicks ain't got enough talent for them to carry him. You know? Melo, Porzingis, but when them three go to the bench, what else we got then? You want to weigh in on that, Mike Ray?
What about what?
He said that Moody ain't got enough talent in Denver to carry them. So what makes him think that if the Knicks would have drafted him, they wouldn't have had Porzingis. They would just had Carmelo and Moody.
Well, they probably feel like Carmelo and Moody is more of a 1-2 combo because Moody being a guard and Carmelo being a scorer. But I think that might have taken, well, I don't know.
But
it would have been a good match, but I think Kris was the way to go because Kris, you know, barring injury to his foot like Yao Ming, anything like that, Kris is gonna be the face of the league.
But this is my correction to that.
Mm-hmm.
Porzingis to be a 7-3 man, he passes better than some of the small forwards
and
guards out there.
Yeah.
He passes the ball.
Yeah.
He gets the ball to people. So if it's all about a man penetrating, passing the ball and all that, this 7-3 man doing that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, our problem is not what we have on our team now. Our problem is the point guard, you know, because our front
what
line.
What point guard?
The one we have.
Exactly. What point guard?
Yeah.
What point guard?
That's the big problem right there. That's the big problem. Yeah.
Anyway, y'all, Before we hit the end of the show, I got my man in the house. I've been telling y'all about his work. He's an independent contractor. It's my big bro right here, CO Kris Oliver. He's up in the house right now, and he basically is your one-stop shop. If you need HVAC, plumbing, electrical, painting, flooring, carpentry, additions, basement finishings. Matter of fact, him and I just installed an HVAC system in someone's basement not too long ago. His name is Kris Oliver. You can hit him up, 770-875-4821. Again, that's Kris Oliver, my neighbor, CO, 770-875-4821. Say what's up to the folks, man.
What's going on, people?
And he's a smart man. He's a smart man, you know. He roots for the Eagles just like myself, you know. Like he said, hit him up, man. You know, so you can get anything you need done on your system, anything you need done on anything in your house. If your garage door's messed up, he got you on that too. You know what I'm saying?
Well, if he an Eagle fan, I don't know if he want to come on my house.
He's a Giants fan. And yeah, man, but that's my folks right there, y'all. Y'all need anything done, like I said, man, mostly HVAC. If you got problems, it'll be him and I coming out there together. I mean, if it's an install, if not, you know, he can handle you by himself. But anything you need, man, get my man a shops. You know what I'm saying? Tell him the microwave sends you, and you know, he won't treat you like you live in a country club.
They said give a number.
Give a number?
Yeah.
Phone number? Give me a number.
Phone number 770-875-4821.
He gonna repeat it.
That's 770-875-4821.
That's what I'm talking about. And he gonna hook you up for the low, low. That's my man right there, CO Kris Oliver.
Gary Joyner said, no, I'm gonna tell you to type it up. Gary Joyner said, not smart cheering for the Eagles or anything coming from Philly.
No,
he's a damn Mets fan. Hold on, what you talking about, Gary? You a damn Mets fan, man. Don't come over here disrespecting my Eagles up in here. As a matter of fact, what did the Giants do this year?
Hey, man, we made big moves this year.
We made big moves. You know what I'm saying? We fired Chip Kelly. We making big moves.
Speaking of baseball, since you mentioned the Mets, right? How about our Yankees?
We had a couple of
pitchers. All our pitchers got to do is pitch six innings.
Yeah,
but we got the three guy we just signed, of the best closers, you know,
got,
in the league.
He got a
that don't mean nothing.
Yeah,
that don't mean nothing because
he'll be
money and lawyers will get you out of it.
It's 182 games.
Yeah. So we pretty good on that. But seventh, eighth, and ninth.
Vince, what Vince Cubs gonna do? Or, I mean, his twins gonna do? Oh wait a minute. What is Oakland A's gonna do? What is White Sox? Matter of fact, what is Tampa Bay Devil? What is Tampa Bay Rays gonna do?
What is all 30 of Vince teams gonna do?
What we is love all you, Gov. Do, huh? We love you, Gov. You just got too many teams, baby. Gov say don't matter what in baseball.
Yes.
He wins in the World Series every year.
Yes, because he got every team jersey it is out there.
Jungle Brother says only two things I like in Philly: cheesesteaks and directions out of Philly. Yeah, and you couldn't make it in Philly. You couldn't make it in Philly. Roll out. Grego says, are y'all talking any NASCAR Daytona 500 tomorrow? Now, we don't talk no NASCAR around this part. I see you got the Daytona stuff for your...
Grego.
All I know is they drive fast.
Grego, you on the wrong podcast if you're talking about NASCAR. You need to find that podcast that's about 18 dials down the channel.
Now, Grego, man, like... What is it like...
We got...
Folks in the background, what is it like watching those cats drive around for like 300 laps, man? I can't watch it do the same thing 300 times. Kind of hard.
Yeah. But
we coming up on the end of the show, man.
Yeah.
About to be at that 120 marker.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a good one, man.
Oh man, we ain't no time in the day. Hours in the day.
Non-stop, non-pack. But like I said earlier, we'll go against any show out here, you know.
And it's gonna be the start of the many, man. We're gonna post a lot of these on SME starting now. And we're gonna make it do what it do. It's the bottom to the top show. Jerzey Vern, Chief Rocker. Jon Fisher, the Microwave. Jerz, tell them folks where they can find you on social media.
You can find me on Facebook. That's Vernon Ricks, Chief Rocker Jerzey Vern. You can find me on Twitter, the same snapshot. You can find me on Instagram, the same thing. And my email address is AtlantaJerzey@yahoo.com.
All right, y'all can find me on social media at Jon Fisher, JonFisher. You can find me on Twitter at JFish the Microwave. Leave the V and the E off. You can find me on what else am I on? Periscope at JFish the Microwave. What you got on Periscope, Jerz?
I got three sites. I got the Chief Rocker Jerzey Vern, I got Jerzey Vern, I got Vernie Ricks.
All of those Periscopes. Like I said, you can find me at JFish the Microwave on Periscope. My email is, I have two of them, at JFishTheMicrowave@gmail.com and Papito, P-A-P-I-T-O, 646 at gmail.com.
Jungle Brother said, Fish, what is it like watching your bum ass Eagles? Question. Oh, my bad. You got cable, not DirecTV. Laugh out loud.
Man, tell Jungle back up. Jungle, if we have more time up in here, you get your ass lit up, man. But we got to close the show out, man. Y'all keep it 100 out there in them streets. I'm keeping 100 with yourselves. Otherwise, you can't keep it 50 with nobody else. Signing off for myself, Jon Fisher, the Microwave, my partner, Jerzey Vern, Chief Rocker.
Boom shakalaka.
Had a great show, man. Wish we had more time, but we can only put, you know, a certain amount of time out today. We're going to make it do what it do, man. Like I said, it's the first of many shows. We took y'all from the beginning to the present, and now it's time to go from the present to the future, man. This show going to rock. We're trying to do big things. We got some, you know, we had some good interviews today. Shouts out to everybody who was in the chat room, Jungle Brother. Gary G Money joined us, the host of Everyday People Show, Jungle Brother, the Dr. Dre of Real Cash Radio, Sports Governor of Minnesota, Vince Wright, Bus jumped up in here, Grego jumped up in here, of course my partner and I were in the chat room,
Tony Switch
was up in here for a quick little minute,
Gary G Money.
G Money, yeah. We called him out already. Who else? Old Man Cuddy was up in here for a minute. Diplomat, that ninja was up in here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? This was a wonderful show, man. Appreciate all y'all doing what y'all do for us. You know what I'm saying? We try to do what we can do. Curtis Brown. Who's that? Brown from the D where they will slap your ass.
Yes, sir.
Pause. Yeah, man. Wonderful show, y'all. Y'all keep it 100. We ain't got enough time to play no track closing out. But for me and my partner, we are gone.
Peace.
Shakalaka.